Well, good morning, Newcastle, and a very pleasant welcome to the morning show. Morning show. Yeah, Morning News Watch. As I'm a little bit ahead of myself, but getting everything is now intact. We, interesting enough, thank you, Susan Bennett. We, interesting enough, this morning have had some peculiarities as we've streamed through on what we're doing, but
Because
there's one thing turned off and there's another thing turned off. So we got that taken care of. It's Friday, folks, October 4th. And as we make our way through the day, hope you're gonna do something fallish. Something to have some fun this weekend. The weather's supposed to be that cool fall type weather, 60s. And it'll be just great to get out, see a little, feel a little sunshine, see a little sunshine, that warmth. And yet that temperature not being real high. We'll give you a Lawrence County 45 weather and really get that out there to you. We had a huge mailbag, and we're going to tell you why as we go through. People are really picking up and watching us in Mercer, Butler, even over in Mahoning County. And I'd like to thank them for their viewership. You know, that anytime on your time concept goes through, and it's great to be able to just pick up without any big fancy heavy equipment and watch what you want to watch when you want to watch it. Now I have my coffee right here, and I can tell you that the train is on the tracks, and Newswatch Morning is straight ahead for you.
Broadcasting from the greatest castle in the world. In the County of Lawrence, NCTV 45.
Entrusting your loved one to a funeral director is a very personal and emotional decision. The funeral director you choose must understand the importance of the decision you have made. When you call the William and Roger DiCarbo Funeral Home, I recognize what a privilege it is to be chosen at your time of need. We will provide you and your family with the best service possible, with sincerity and compassion.
The William and Roger DiCarbo Funeral Home, family owned and operated since 1941.
If you're craving hot dogs and more, and you're in the area, then look no farther than Coney Island, downtown Newcastle on Kennedy Square.
Bill's Bake Shop will make you happy. Owner Bill Cast and his staff keep the tradition going with all those bakery items you remember as a kid. Just to name a few, Bill makes cream sticks, cinnamon rolls, bear claws, cream horns, cannoli, cakes, pies, cookies, bread, pizza, and more. You can also buy homemade Cavatelli and ravioli. Bill's Bake Shop, located 228 North Liberty Street in the Mahoningtown section of Newcastle, is open Tuesday through Saturday, 7 to 5, and Sunday, 7 to 2, closed Monday. Bill's, where smiles are everywhere. Call 724-654-4223.
Hams for one great dining experience.
We're back, folks, and yes, I got my cup of coffee right here, and it's good to have you along. Let's take that first look at weather, and you can tell everything has changed. Outside, 57 degrees. Humidity, 78%, but it's low. Winds are from the northwest, and dew point 50. It just feels great. Kind of like fall. And that's a good thing to feel. Now, topping our stories, and you know, with that fall feeling, a lot of fall activities. Okay, up in Franklin, from Friday to Sunday, it's Apple Fest. So that's one thing to get out and do. Now, get ready. This doesn't make any sense to me. It's Apple Fest 37, but they didn't say where. Lawrence County Fairgrounds is having the Lawrence County Scaregrounds, and that is Saturday at 4 p.m. And there's the 11th annual Autumn Festival at Hermitage Agway. So you might want to stop by that. We're going to update you on plenty of other fall activities as time permits, and we'll talk about those things going on. Now, this, you know, I'm sorry. I don't want to get on my pulpit and start yapping so early. But first of all, there isn't anybody around that's not going to say Chris Sinod isn't a nice guy. However, he goes to these totally meaningless meetings. Okay, Chris, a well-trained workforce is needed in Pennsylvania. Chris, every time jobs attempt to come to Newcastle, something happens. You gotta be on job of putting them here first, then recruiting the workforce to live, play, and enjoy Newcastle, PA. Let me kind of twist this for you, because you're not getting us any jobs any other way, okay? And sitting on this thing that says the workforce needs trained, every press release that I've seen come in, that training happens in the eastern part of the state. There are jobs out there, but it matters making sure the training is available to get help. In a public hearing to discuss the workforce opportunities, the unions offered to connect people with a living wage. Workforce development is great, but you got to be able to produce the jobs, Chris. And quite humbly, Chris, I think you're missing it. You got a great smile. You go to every festival, white, tell everybody happy birthday, but we got to get something in here. You know, in my lifetime, especially since you've been in office, I don't recall one job coming to Newcastle, Pennsylvania. That's just it. You know, we got another guy saying he believes in small business, just not this small business because he won't walk through the door. That's Chris Fry. So, enough on that. Now, the Employment First Commission announces recommendations to help people with disabilities find competitive, fulfilling jobs. As part of the commitment, and this is state news just to let you know, as part of the commitment, Governor Wolf announced the inaugural Employment First Oversight Commission annual report. The report outlines goals and recommendations for the Commonwealth to continue prioritizing competitive integrative employment for Pennsylvanians with disabilities. In 2016, the governor signed an executive order adopting an Employment First policy with the goal of making Pennsylvania a model state for employing people with disabilities. Policy was codified by Act 36 in 2018, which also created a commission. And so the commission has been created. Recommendations will allow people with disabilities to work in a variety of community by providing improved training. Okay. And so that's out there. State of Pennsylvania. PennDOT recommends that October 2020 federal enforcement deadline for a real ID. And anybody that knows, going to get the real ID up at the DMV here in Newcastle, it has been a challenge because they are backed up out the wazoo. To date, more than 400,000 Pennsylvanians have chosen the real ID based on data from other states. The option of the real ID program PennDOT adopts anticipated that approximately 1.3 million of its customers will get a real ID before the federal deadline of October 1, 2020. We are pleased that so many Pennsylvanians have been provocated and have chosen to get their real ID. Okay. PennDOT must verify the following documents: proof of identity, proof of social security number, two proofs of current physical PA address, and proof of legal name changes if applicable. So that gives you some real ID information. And let's take a break and go to sports. And how about that football game last night? 30-29, the Seahawks prevail on a missed field goal. A missed winning field goal. Pens drop a decision to Buffalo 3-1 on the ice. Dodgers top Washington 6-0. So let's take a look at sports, and we'll be right back.
The Cedars Restaurant in Newcastle wants you to indulge in the food from their pleasing menu. The Cedars features Mediterranean, pub food, Middle Eastern cuisine, and so much more. They're open every day, 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. Call the Cedars on the east side at 827 Addis Street, Newcastle, 724.
Sylvan Heights Golf Course in Newcastle, Pennsylvania features many amenities, lush fairways, and great greens, and many challenging shots. Your crowd will applaud. A short drive from Butler, Sharon, Pittsburgh, Elwood, and Youngstown. It's Sylvan Heights Golf Course in Newcastle, Pennsylvania.
Hello and welcome to the Cedar Sports Corner. And for you NBA fans that have waited, well, it's opening night. The Pacers take on Sacramento. Well, Franca takes on the Brooklyn Nets. So NBA now up and running with their preseason schedule. Over in Major League Baseball, well, Friday, Tampa Bay at Houston, the Cardinals at the Braves, the Twins at the Yankees, and late game, the Nationals of Washington take on the Dodgers. Now, this is why this is just like a sportsman's dream. You have, that was basketball, baseball, and now, why not a little hockey? Your hockey, the Blackhawks of Chicago, take on the Philadelphia Flyers. The Toronto Maple Leafs take on the Columbus Blue Jackets. The Winnipeg Jets take on the New Jersey Devils. And the Washington Caps. It's not the Caps. Yeah, I guess it is. Washington takes on the Rangers. And Vegas takes on San Jose. You know, with that Washington thing, why would you put an eagle rather than a capital? Maybe. Now, let's go to one more thing, and that's college football. Because, you know, after all, these colleges are starting to play on Friday. Now, your Friday matchups in college football, number 18, UCF, Central Florida, takes on Cincinnati at Cincinnati. New Mexico takes on San Jose State at San Jose State. Now, remember that we'll have the game, homecoming, as the Newcastle Red Hurricane at home against the Blackhawk Cougars. Stay tuned, watch, and maybe we hope to see you at the game too. Nice night for football. We're going to take this time out. Go on over to Cedars, get some great food, a beverage, and
the Cedars Restaurant in Newcastle wants you to indulge in the food.
This program furnished by Sporting Goods, 23 East Washington Street, Newcastle. Call 724-658-2535.
This program brought to you by Cummings Landscaping and Design. Brandon Cummings, mower operator. Penn, Ohio Bottled Water Company. Home, residential, commercial, water coolers. You can contact us Monday through Friday, 8 to 5 p.m. We're fast, efficient, and we deliver water. We offer 100% customer satisfaction guarantee. Contact us today at 724-498-4760.
We have a full restaurant. I mean, it's a full menu. We're doing like a signature steak in with lamb. It's blackened and it's absolutely delicious. We're doing a pasta. We're trying to do the vegetarian. So we got an own menu for just the vegetarian. We have three bars There is one bar here, and there is another bar in the back next to the banquet, and that's kind of nice because you have your own bar when you do the weddings and stuff. The bar opens at 5 usually. Okay, and I mean, if you come in and you want a beer at 3 o'clock, I will open up for you. You know, that's no problem. This is the only place in this whole area that really has a hotel next to a restaurant and a bar. We have a huge banquet room. We can sit up to at least 750 people. And, you know, we have it all here. We have music, we got DJs, we got a grand baby piano. We have the piano bar, we got intimate little bar, or we got for bigger parties, or we got for huge parties. We will do whatever we can do to make you happy.
Welcome back, and always glad to have you here on Newswatch. Again, I have to go out and tell you thank you. As in all the categories that come in, and we're up. Our viewership has increased again by 83%. And that being the case, you're telling a friend and having a friend tell a friend. And I thank you for it. For those people giving you fake news, just tell them you watch NCTV 45. We get to how you're feeling. We get to what is best for Newcastle, Lawrence County. And we give you the facts, not some glimmering other stuff. Now, with this story coming up next, Department of Agriculture encourages Pennsylvanians to make memories on the farm this fall. And you know, I couldn't agree more. As especially if you have young kids, you can actually do things for little or no cost right here at home in Lawrence County, and it'll seem like a big deal to the kids. You know, we have Iron Mill Farms, and we've told you about it. We have Cheeseman's, and to a lesser extent, but not last but not least, but we have Apple Castle. You can go get some great pumpkins, get some apples, and make an apple pie. Kids would love that. Go to one of the farms and just see the fall harvest coming in, which, you know, the farmers markets are open just a few more weeks, if that. This is just a spectacular time. Yesterday when I was at Allie's Upper Crust, and you probably saw, I got a nice hamburger roll-up. And it was absolutely phenomenal. And I carried my hot pepper around. It stuck it right in there. You know, and we have so many. How about this? How about JoJo's? Does anybody? No, I'm not talking about a Boss Gag song. JoJo's downtown, a new sponsor coming on right next to Pizza Man's Pizza. Fantastic stuff in there. And a lot of great fall items. Seasons change right down the hall here. And Tony's Lounge. You already saw Caravan Abagio. A lot of great things to be able to see and do right here in what I call the greatest castle in the world. Okay. And if you're not, excuse me, if you're not doing them, then you're missing out. Now, here's some pictures. And there's a reason I'm giving you these pictures. And I'm going to tell you about them. And where was the other one? That has to be it. Nope, that's not it. I believe, okay, because this Athena Award is back. And it is a great, great thing. And we'll take a look. Lawrence Mercer County Athena presented the 8th Annual Leadership Awards, honoring women at the New Englander. Okay, the event was recognized by local women, Jennifer Nicholson and Jessica Patton. Now, the first one here is Jennifer Nicholson, and this is Jessica Patton. Okay. Young professional leadership recipient Jessica Patton of the Newcastle Area School District. Okay. Now, this Athena's founded over 30 years ago, does a great job at helping women and recognizing those in leadership roles. The Athena Group is headquartered in Chicago. So you know. So hats off to those girls for a great, great time. Really appreciate that. Now, it's time to check out Lawrence County 45 weather. And, well, you know, out there, not too bad, but it feels great. 56, the humidity now, bumped up to 81% from when we first started the broadcast. Winds from the northwest at 6, barometric pressure 30.16, 2.15, visibility 10 miles. And when you check local radar, what do you see? Pretty clear. That's ground clutter, folks. And nothing around us. Let's go to Lawrence County 45 weather and check out what this forecast for you and the weekend holds in store. Once again to Lawrence County 45 weather. Well, after last night's scattered showers, a low of 53, how are things looking? Well, you know, one thing is that the rain is clearing out, and that's a good thing. As you can see on local radar, really clear in our area. There's some stuff up on the lake, but nothing to write home about there. The national scene shows clearing to the west, but with the flow from the north, west, it's going to mean cooler temperatures. And let's see just how cool that is. Your Friday, isolated showers in 61. Now there's only a 20% chance, so nothing there. Mostly clear Friday night in 41. Are you getting the drift now? Saturday, sunny in 66. Saturday night, mostly cloudy, 55. Sunday, mostly cloudy, 70, 60% chance of rain. And then Sunday night, mostly cloudy, 51, 60% chance of rain. Along comes Monday. Mostly cloudy, a high of 63. Chance of precipitation, 50%. Monday night, partly cloudy, a low of 45. Tuesday rolls in, mostly sunny and 62. Tuesday night, mostly clear, 42. And Wednesday, sunshine and 64. Now, you can see that the temperatures, now from the really hot time, they've gone down 20 degrees, but mostly a decrease into the 60s. And overnight lows, low 50s, 40s. And that's a little more seasonal. This was Lawrence County Standing 45 Weather.
Is brought to you by NCTV 45 and NC Radio 450, Newcastle's community television station.
Nico & Sons Sales and Service, 347 East Washington Street, Newcastle, has lawnmowers of every type. Zero turn country clippers, Bainey USA, 42 inch to 54 inch cut. Batteries by Oregon. They'll service at your home or their shop. Service specials start as low as $69. Call Jim Micko and Sons, 724-652-6911.
If you're having a party, then Keystone Specialty is the place you need to go. Yes, they have every party supply that you can imagine. Planning that wedding, that graduation, or maybe it's just that big game that's coming up, go to Keystone Specialty. Party supplies and so much more. Remember, they have those fall decorations, winter, spring, and summer. It's Keystone Specialty on the south side of Newcastle, Hill Street.
Vinte Se in Newcastle is a premier winery located on Newcastle's southeast side on Wilson Avenue. Vinte Se open Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Features a variety of fine wines and also fine food. Vinte Se for the very best.
Today's programming is brought to you by NCTV 45 and NC Radio 450, Newcastle's community television station.
Get the dance bar before the rooster crows. Yes, it's Tony's Lounge, complete with a great bar, pool, yes, jukebox, and a great seating area that is unbelievable. It'll make you hungry, and a wide selection to choose from, including wings. Yes, specials too. Don't monkey around. Get to Tony's Lounge. Well, and welcome to those newest sponsors on NCTV 45. And it just makes sense when you think about the number of people watching. Now, as we go through going to give you some reminders. Snow Queen down at the Playhouse tonight. That is 7:30 to 9:30. Check out the Playhouse, 724-654-3437. Also remember that downtown here, the Farmers Market, Elwood, Newcastle, well, New Wilmington, be open this weekend on Saturday. The deadline, Monday, is the deadline to register to vote. The 29th is the deadline for absentee ballots. You got 3 days to get them in. And then the election, November 4th. So make sure that that's on your remember type thing. Remember that Cheeseman's is open this weekend and Iron Mill Farms for some great fall stuff. And also, don't forget that the Newcastle Red Hurricane, why, they'll be on the field tonight against Blackhawk, great rivalry, and it's homecoming. So just a few great positive things happening throughout the day, the weekend. Make sure you get out and do them. And say hello to these fine sponsors who keep community television on the air for you.
There's more than meets the eye. Gotta give them a Newcastle a try. They're a small town for living. Look around.
Special thanks going out to Town Mall Pizza for sponsorship of this program, located in the Cascade Galleria, Newcastle.
At our law firm, we see you. Come see us at lgkg.com.
These fine businesses provided funding for this program. Gatherings, Town and Country, and On Target. Today's programming is brought to you by NCTV 45 and NC Radio 450, Newcastle's community television station.
Okay, well, we're back, and that's going to do it here for Newswatch Morning. Hopefully, you go out and tell a friend, and have a friend tell a friend about NCTV 45. Remember, we're available anytime on your time. Yes, a train that runs on your schedule. That's NCTV 45 right here in Newcastle, Lawrence County. And by all means, as you make your way through, make sure that you get that second cup of coffee and have a super day in what I call the greatest castle in the world, in the county of Lawrence. And every day about this time, we take and leave you with that little song that will boost you through everything you got. So here we go with, and as my, one second, folks, when you got, I got to do this. There you go. And as we go through, here's Rock and Roll Band by Boston. Have a great day, everybody, and we'll see you again real soon.